I know we could really use some great good news, okay? And that's what this channel is all about. Because we have some unbelievably great news for you to offset all of the, you know, horrible stuff that the world keeps churning out and the media keeps amplifying, etc. We have the best news possible. That is, there are no layers, there are no levels. Not a one of us has fallen into any pit of layers and levels, the pit of becoming. Not a one of us has fallen into any pit of becoming. In fact, there is no pit of becoming. There is no pit of becoming whatsoever. We are simply hallucinating this, dreaming it, imagining it. But no one has actually fallen into any pit of becoming. There is only one being, and we are it. And this is the best news possible. There is no greater news than this, actually. And we can actually see this. We can actually experience this fact as a fact. It is a fact. We are simply believing that there's all these layers and levels, and there are no layers and levels to reality. This is reality. All is reality. There are no layers and levels to reality whatsoever. There's absolutely nothing we need to do to make it so. We don't need to get out of some pit. There is no pit. We don't need to avoid falling into some pit. There is no pit to fall into. Now, what would be nice, I ask the Holy Spirit, we can ask the Holy Spirit for this. Is Holy Spirit, how about someone here who can see this fact all the time? How about that, you know? Can that be in the cards? I've been asking that for a long time. I know it's there, but it sure be nice for someone who just is aware of this, completely aware of this all the time. That would be very nice indeed. To offset what's going on in this world, which is just terrible. I mean, you can't click on any internet page anymore. It's such an absolute cesspool, the internet, actually. It's always been from the very beginning, but it's getting worse, if that's possible. We've refined it. It's a refined cesspool. And it's like no matter where you click, you're going down into some sort of massive septic system. Never to be heard of again. And so, you know, our attention has to be galvanized onto something vastly superior than just the, hey, gee, look at this technology, I can click here. Whoops, look at this page. Horrible. You know, one side's the hideousness, and the other side is all the models, you know, and so we need something to galvanize us out of this septic system, which is the internet, which is the television, which is the society, which is the culture, which is the world, and that's being very kind. It's saying it's a septic system is sugarcoating it entirely. And the good news is nobody's actually down there. There is no there. There is no septic system actually existent. We're all a abiding in the absolute purity. We're abiding in absolute purity. Everyone is abiding in absolute purity. All is abiding in absolute purity right now. This is a fact. And yet we act like we're not. So theoretically, it's easy. Practically, it's not so easy to recognize this. So it sure be a big help if there were those here in the world who abided in this. You know, recognition, sure, we can get glimpses of it, but abiding in it from a practical standpoint, that's quite tremendous, actually. Quite tremendous. And then maybe we could get our attention onto that. Because that's the truth of the whole situation. That's the absolute truth. Doesn't matter what these dream figures are doing here in the world at all. Doesn't matter at all. This is just a three-dimensional virtual reality. Imagine a hallucination of a pit and of becoming. But spirit is not in any pit of becoming at all. And what bodies do, form does, makes absolutely no difference. It's just appearance, just one condition called appearance. And it has no layers and levels to it at all. So it's totally irrelevant. So it should be beneficial to have someone we could, that would galvanize, you know, a spark. We need a spark. Theory is fine, but the spark, you know, is just different. It's the difference between like looking at a, you know, a sheet music and looking at all the notes on a piece of paper and then actually hearing the band playing the song and singing it, you know. It's a huge difference, isn't it? We're just looking at the sheet music and saying, gee, this would be a lovely song. It probably might be a nice song if we could hear. And then hear the band play it, we're just, wow. You know, it's like that. We know this can happen. This happened before. There have been those in this world who abided in the recognition. All is perfect. All is well. Totally perfect. No problem whatsoever. There's nothing to fall into, no pit of becoming to fall into. We all is. Always is. This happened before, so why not now? That's why I keep saying, why not now? Why not now? I can't fathom why not now. Keep looking. I've been looking and looking and looking and looking for decades. Is there anyone here really who's really abiding in that? You see, abiding in that. That's a galvanizer, true galvanizer. I have not found anyone yet. Galvanizer's different. They look at you different. They're seeing your spirit. They're seeing you as spirit. They're overlooking your body circumstances entirely in terms of fact. They know that this is just a symbol, a dream symbol, actually. Bodies are just dream symbols that don't mean anything, actually. Don't need to mean anything. We don't need to symbolize that there's no pit? Because there's no pit there. So why should we need to symbolize that there's no pit there? So they just simply see us, the whole situation, as it actually is. That's a quiet mind. I've tried to take teachers from the past who are this way and bring them into the present, so we could pay attention to them, you know, their videos, their pictures, and get it from that. It hasn't seemed to work, hasn't seemed to work out. It's very strange what's going on here in the world, how things have not worked out. It just doesn't seem that people here get it at all. This is a dream. This is all symbolic. All of this is completely symbolic. A dream of becoming. Dream of becoming, as your own way of putting it. A dream of levels and layers and adjustments and all this is. Spirit, there isn't any such scenario in reality at all. And then we think, well, this is a separate reality. No, it's not. It's a hallucination. It's an interpretation. It's a misinterpretation. It's a misinterpretation. A misperception. The light just went on. Interesting. I don't see anything to trigger it. Just went on. Well, that's interesting. So people don't know what to do, how to be helped. You just pay attention to that which knows you are spirit. You're not a body, you're spirit. You're not in any pit of becoming at all. You don't need to interpret any depth in any story about bodies. You don't need to see any story involving bodies at all. There is no history, his story, or her story about bodies at all. Nothing's ever happened. Nothing's ever happened. Nothing ever will happen with bodies. So there's never been any his story, and there never will be any her story either. It's all much ado about nothing, nothing, nothing. There's no becoming. There's no layers and levels. Being is not in a condition of becoming at all. It's only dreaming that it is. And this dream is totally inconsequential, 100% inconsequential. So what meaning does all this have? It has no meaning. All this bodies and activity has no meaning, actually. We try to give it meaning through death. That too has no meaning. There's no meaning to any of it. Nothing but crickets. You know, we hear the crickets here. Watched a video of this temple in Dehradun. Ananda Mahima Ashram Temple in Dehradun. Nobody there, nothing going on. Just in the background, I just heard crickets. There's crickets. It's a dream, there's a dream, and sometimes someone shows up in the dream and says, hey, this is all a dream. There's a dream of becoming, it's meaningless. And then they seem to leave the dream, and people forget all about them, and they're back, their tension's back on bodies, and what are bodies doing, and what's the news, what's the progress we're doing, bodies. Same crickets are just playing everywhere. dream of becoming, which is really the dream of trying to become something different than what we are, so that we can dwell in some place other than reality and pretend that we're greater than God, all of which is totally impossible. There's no such scenario possible. So, you know, do you have karma? In many ways you can say no. It's meaningless. All of this activity of body is completely meaningless. At every step of the way it's meaningless. And this is confounding to us because we keep thinking that we're making progress. No one's making any progress. So we think, well, I mean, I could have stopped this dreaming a long time ago. Yes, absolutely. But I thought that, well, of course, we all think we're making progress, but we're not. It's always 100% meaningless. So we're not progressing towards any meaning at all in this dream. Dream of becoming is meaningless. But we think, well, I've worked so hard on this becoming, and look, I used to be down here, now I'm up here, and... No, nothing's ever happened. Nothing's ever happened. It's tough to see that, but it's true. We're just imagining the lows and the highs, and then imagining a path from the low to the high. And imagining that this is progress. But remember, we imagine the whole thing, the lows and the highs, and the so-called evolution from the low to the high, that's prearranged in our imagination, so we can define it as progress, say, oh, we are progressing. But if you're imagining both the low and the high are both completely imaginary, and the path from the low to the high is also completely imaginary, what meaning is there to it? None. But we assume there's meaning to it. There isn't. So we just assume, well, yeah, we start out in this primordial ooze, and we gradually develop, you know, organisms, amino acids, proteins, amino acids, organisms, and gradually, you know, we've gotten more and more complex, and this is all a dream of becoming. We're dreaming the entire dream, and it's set up dualistically from the very beginning. The purpose is to make an illusion of progress. An illusion of progress. So in order to make an illusion of progress, you set up a polarized dream where there's the low and the high, so to speak. So then you have something go from the low to the high, and then you can claim, oh, you see, there's progress was made. We need to see this as the self-deception that it is. Remember, we wanted to give the illusion of progress in becoming. So how do you do that? Just like saying what we've done. It's like in a dream, you say, well, I want to show the illusion of a journey. So you set up a dream, a landscape, and you dream one place, and then far away you dream another place, and then you dream of the journey from one place to the other place, and say, oh, look at all the progress they're making in a journey. They're getting closer, they're getting closer, they're getting closer. Dream fantasy. There's no closer in a dream, really, is there? There's no farther away or closer in a dream. It's all being imagined, hallucinated, the whole thing. So this dream of becoming, we're not becoming anything. There's no becoming. We're just defining the changes of our hallucinating as saying, well, we're becoming. We're not becoming anything. There is no such thing as becoming. We are. Isness is isness. There's no becoming. This is just a dream, and we're just defining what's happening as if it were becoming. No, there's just shifts in complexity and shifts in the complexity of the figures in the dream, you know, prearranged. So we start out simple and become complex, and then we can say the difference between the simple and complex equals becoming. No, it doesn't. That's a false equation. We just have defined it that way. Are we, is this organism more advanced towards becoming? Does the more sophistication of complexity towards what was before, does that mean that the process of becoming has happened? No, that's totally something that we have defined it as. It has no intrinsic truth to whatsoever. No intrinsic. It's like you have a pumpkin, and you're growing pumpkins, and each year we have pumpkin growing contest here in Northern California. It's a big deal in Western states, and we grow giant pumpkins. And so let's say one year you grow 100 pounds, you get better, next year bigger. And finally one year you bring in one that's like, you know, big as like a shed. I mean, a gigantic pumpkin. And everybody's there, they're looking at it and say, wow. And somebody stands up and says, folks, I want you to know, you see where I started out, and I started out with growing a 100-pound pumpkin. Now I've got this thing that's a ton. It's a ton. And everybody says, wow. And he says, you know what, folks? This pumpkin here is almost reached. It's almost to the point where it's going to turn into a solid golden pumpkin. A solid golden pumpkin. You know, that's our goal, right? And if we just get it big enough, it's going to turn into a solid gold pumpkin. And everyone says, yeah, you're almost there. You're almost there. Wow. Maybe next year you're going to grow and it's going to turn into a solid gold pumpkin. This is completely made up. Completely made up. So we're saying, well, we got these little organisms, amoeba, you know, and now we got this human organisms, you know. And that means that one day human organisms are going to turn into God or something, you know. This is all completely made up. There is no such thing as becoming. There's no such thing. That pumpkin is not going to become solid gold, so to speak, right? The size, the fact that the 1-ton pumpkin's bigger than the 100-pound pumpkin has absolutely nothing to do with a golden pumpkin, except that we have put it there as a story of saying, oh, that's what's about ready to happen. That's the conclusion of this advancement in pumpkin, heavy pumpkin growing. No, it's not. And so we have just brought up this notion of some sort of conclusion to what we're doing in this dream of more, so, you know, more complexity, and that we've just invented the goal is, oh, there's a goal to be reached. No, there's no goal. There's no goal. You don't reach some sort of, you know, new realm. Becoming doesn't lead us into some new realm. There is no becoming happening. We're not becoming something different than what we are.
No.
I think that we say, oh, we're going to become something different, that we're almost there. No, no, that's something we've just completely made up, 100% made up, just like that golden pumpkin story. Made it up, and we want to believe it's true. Now, the fact that nothing's happening here at all is okay, because you can see the being that has always been present. So it's not like you're going to fall into a void of unhappiness. In fact, you're going to be actually genuinely happy. Say, wow, look at all this being. There's no becoming at all. This is wonderful, 100% being. So it's good news, very good news. And say, oh, there's no golden pumpkin, but this pumpkin right here, it's actually abiding in absolute pure spaciousness. And the littler pumpkin, also abiding in absolute pure spaciousness. And this and this and everything is abiding in absolute pure spaciousness right now. So we're not so sad to see the dream of becoming, you know, let it go. No golden pumpkin, but don't need a golden pumpkin. Of course, if you see everything as being, you won't see any even dream of becoming, will you? I mean, you'll still see everything, but there's no dream of becoming. You don't interpret it that way anymore. People have to get their minds into this, you know, get into this, get into it actually. Otherwise, the story of becoming is going to sweep your imagination, it's going to fire your imagination up, and you're going to get swept into, you know, worshiping the golden pumpkin that will never show up. And that's no fun at all, actually. It may feel whimsical and adventurous for a while, but eventually it turns sour, very sour, because you become obsessed with growing bigger pumpkins and frantic about it and upset, compulsive about it, and you start saying, I need to control everything to grow a bigger pumpkin. I gotta control myself, I gotta control everybody else. Oh, somebody gotta, I gotta control everyone's thoughts, you know, whatever you can control, I gotta control everything, because somehow we haven't been able to grow the golden pumpkin yet, so we know we can do it, it's just we have to make sure that every last parameter is totally examined and totally under control and totally manipulated in the right way. And so you just become absorbed like a black hole of obsession with this nonsensical story. There isn't any golden pumpkin, so why are you absorbed by any of that? It doesn't matter. None of it matters. And that's why none of this world matters. What happens? There's no reason to be absorbed by anything that's happening here, because nothing is happening. Nothing ever will happen. Nothing needs to happen. Nothing needs to happen. Nothing needs to happen or not happen. And so we need to get our spiritually sparked to pay attention to this and say that this is better than paying attention to the world's story of what's happening to people, what's happening to bodies, what's happening to the world, what's going on here. That will pull you into the black hole of severe, severe obsession, where your attention just, you feel like it's in prison. It's just tied down in so many different ways to pay attention to this and this and this and this, and there's a million, millions, endless parameters you need to pay attention to, you think, in order to be successful, in order to be happy, in order to achieve the end of the story. There is no end of the story because there is no story. That this is the realization. There's no end to the story because there isn't any story. There's no beginning to the story, actually, either. There's just no story. And we're so used to talking about endings and beginnings, it's so difficult to shift into just no story. There's no story. Instead of history, it's no story. No story. It's not history, it's not her story, it's no story. No story. No story. And so then everything is unlinked, as it were, from any story. Everything just is exactly as it is, without any actual relationship to anything else at the table. Everything is relationship. It already is. It is. All is abiding in pure spaciousness. There's nothing that needs to happen between a table and a chair. They're not actually linked in the way we think. They're part of the one family. All is all. You don't have to have any functional linkage between anything. In terms of, you know, functional linkage has to do with a story. You know, this is here, and you think the rock is here, and the garden is here, and you think that, you know, this is helping move the story along, but actually everything just is. Free, totally free of any story. What we do is we put storylines on everything. Everything we see is part of a story. We never just see the isness of everything, because we think we have to move the props along here of the story. Form doesn't have any story to tell. So set form free. Set yourself free of form, actually. This will dawn upon us. Jesus says truth can only dawn upon an unclouded mind. Well, that's a pretty high parameter. How do you get the unclouded mind? You see, it'd be nice if the dawn were to kind of, you know, cause the shadows to dissipate. But, you know, if that's what he says, that's what it is. So we need to clear the clouds away, which is what we're doing. So there is no story relationship between anything. Everything is free, immaculately pure, right this instant. So what is it? What need does it have? Anything have for a story, actually? You see, there's the question. What need does anything have for becoming? Everything already is right now. So we can see the isness of everything. We can be aware of it. And then everything is completely sacred. There's no need for anything to evolve, to grow, to go through some process, through some storyline. Absolutely no need for it. Now we can keep functioning just fine, but that we're not weaving any story at all. We're just functioning with all this isness. You know, drink. We'll just drink our root beer still. But nothing is happening in terms of story of becoming. All is. So there's no hero of the dream. There's no hero. there's no hero because there's no journey. There's no story. Because you wonder, what do I do with this body? I thought I was supposed to be the hero. Now you see, there's no hero. Only a zero. Yes. So, the isness. We're getting there. We're very close to this. We're able to just look at this in a lighthearted, clear, you know, non-intense. It's just easy. Just say, okay, yeah, this really resonates. The immediate isness of everything is the immediate isness of everything right now. No story. Nothing has to be adjusted at all. Not even the slightest particle needs to be adjusted in location or any way for the total isness to be present right now and to recognize it. There's no story taking place, actually. It's just our superimposition of our desire that there be, but it's not actually there. Okay, so this is great, good news, and hopefully this will dawn here, and we'll get fired up for that, okay? All right, great, that's it.